Welcome, dear viewers, to Couch Warrior TV on YouTube. I am the Couch Warrior, and you are watching Arcanus Arcana, a Skyrim Let's Play. This is Chapter 2, Part 2, and if you remember from our last episode, we snuck into Windhelm, and we entered the home of this Aretino boy, Aventus Aretino. And in our discussion with him, we were able to actually convince him that we were a member of the Dark Brotherhood and take control of his contract. Just a quick refresher. As the story goes here, Fleet is trying to find out as much as he can about the underworld of Skyrim, mainly because he wants to find a way to locate and associate himself with a thieves guild. Being new to Skyrim, he doesn't exactly know where to start looking. So far, he's heard rumors about the Dark Brotherhood, the Assassin's Guild. So the logic behind our pursuit is that if we endeavor to try to locate the Assassin's Guild, the likelihood may increase that we may also find the Thieves Guild in the process. So far, we have not been able to scare up any rumors or anything regarding the location of the Thieves Guild or their activities. So, with no other lines to pursue, we've been following this Dark Brotherhood intelligence, which has brought us here to Windhelm. So, in the last episode, we came into Windhelm stealthily. We came in through the door around the docks rather than the front door. I think we've successfully managed to get into the city without really presenting ourselves to any guards. The objective here is that we want to come into the city, do our business, and quietly leave. So we've come in the dead of night, and I'm going to take advantage of this opportunity. I have snuck over to the marketplace. I'm going to take care of some smithing. I'm going to take care of some enchanting stuff, lighten my load a little bit. And then we are going to sneak back out of the city, and hopefully there will be no memory of us ever having been here. See, I still don't want to disenchant that. I don't know, I never put the thing on. I should probably just disenchant it and get it over with, but for some reason, I don't. So the next course of action here is what we've learned from Aventus is he has given us a contract for the assassination of Grella the Kind, who runs the orphanage in Riften. So our next destination is Riften. Prior to setting out on the trail, though, I am going to take care of a few items here. I'm always checking to see if I'm high enough level to upgrade my armor yet, and I'm not. So we're going to do a little bit more grinding. I've got some leather and so forth I can use. We'll make some more bracers, you know, some things like that. Get a few more levels in smithing while we have the opportunity. But we're under some time pressure here because we want to get out of the city before the marketplace opens up again and people start hitting the streets. So far we've managed to get in here and do this while only presenting ourselves to, you know, two, maybe three people at the most, which is terrific. Naturally, we don't have the advantage here of an open marketplace, so we can't really buy and sell, but we can still use the facilities that are here, and there's an enchanting table at our disposal. We've also got, you know, all this blacksmithing stuff we can do, so we'll get a bunch of things out of the way here before we head out. But basically, this video is going to be another travel video. Once we leave the city, we're going to head straight overland to Riften. It'll probably take a couple episodes to get there, would be my guess. And then I would anticipate, anyway, that once we arrive in Riften, a lot of time is going to be spent talking to people, gathering intelligence, figuring out what's going on. So I think there could be a stretch of a couple episodes there that are rather low action and more conversation. No real change here.
Spare a coin for an old woman, my lord. Oh, thank you. Divines bless your kind heart.
Our policy is that giving to the beggars of a city is never a bad thing. You never know when you're going to get some nugget of information from them, or they're going to become a useful ally. If anybody's got their finger on the pulse of what's going on in the black markets of the underworld of a city, it's going to be someone who lives on the street. So, no problem there. Made a few more leather strips. Let's make a few more bracers. I think I've done more hunting with this character than I ever have in the past with any previous characters. It's kind of paying off. Between hunting and a little bit of mining when the opportunity presents itself, I do not think that I have paid a nickel for any materials up to this point. So we're only 26 smithing, but that's quite a bit above what we started at. And considering I haven't spent a penny on materials, not too shabby. I already gave you charity, lady. Don't get greedy. All right. I think we've done just about as much as we can do
here.
Will
you spare a few coins to help someone who's got nothing?
We've got a guard here in the marketplace. Severely limits what we can do. I don't think I have anything left to smelt either. Nope. I've converted all my iron ore into ingots. So yeah, we're getting close to dawn.
It's so good.
Time for us to get moving. We definitely want to get outside the city walls before all the merchants wake up and people start leaving their homes. That's just going to end up compromising all the effort that we've put into trying to quietly and invisibly enter the city, so sometimes there's a guard on watch here who patrols. So we're just going to make sure this is clear before we exit. We'll take those. There we go. So I've been thinking about what route I'm going to take to Riften. I'm interested in getting there as quickly as I can. So traveling on the wilderness trails is probably going to be the faster route. However, it is the most treacherous route. There's more likelihood that we're going to run into, you know, bears and wolves and, you know, all those things that are out there lurking. However, I think it's worth the risk. If I take the roads, I'm going to increase my travel time, so we're going to cut overland and take our chances. We're going to count on our wilderness travel techniques to keep us one step ahead of our enemies here. Yeah. So now we've got one guard here at the bottom of the stairs that we have to account for. So we're going to carefully observe, try to locate this guard, and then time our exit with his patrol pattern. There he is, right there. So we're going to hang back, let him get well into his little circle here, and then out we go. Alright, before I hit the water, as I did before, for the sake of role-playing, I'm going to use a potion of Resist Frost. Again, completely unnecessary, but it makes sense in a game, in game terms, in role-playing terms, so we're protecting ourselves from the cold water. And off we go. Right before daybreak. This might actually be a good time to talk a little bit about our build so far. If you're interested in taking a look at what our levels are in various skills, if you look in the show notes, there is a link to Elder Stats, where I've been trying to keep up with our level information. The one thing that I've noticed about Elder Stats, though, is not very helpful is for some reason, I can't, unless it's there and I'm not seeing it, I don't see a place to really record any information about perk selection, which is a huge part of any character build. So, what I'm planning on doing is putting some information on the perks I've chosen in the notes section there. So, if you're curious about where we're at right now, you can always check that. At this point, as far as the core assassin abilities go, I've invested points in 3 levels of overdraw. I believe at this point we also have Eagle Eye. And I believe Power Shot. On the one-handed side, I've got 2 levels invested in Armsman, 2 perks invested in Armsman. And on the stealth side, we're really focused on going up the right-hand side of the stealth constellation. So, at this point, we've acquired 1 level in basic stealth, and then we've done the backstab, and then we've done the additional bow damage. We are just a few levels short of being able to get Assassin Blade, which comes at level 50. We're very, very close to getting that. And that's a priority for us. We've invested a couple of perks in the Conjuration Constellation so that we can increase the damage on our bound weapons. And then we've also gotten a couple of perks in the Illusion Constellation working toward Quiet Casting is our ultimate goal. I think to get to Quiet Casting, don't quote me on this. We've got, I think, 2 perks left to go. At this point, we've done Novice Illusion and Kindred Mage, and then we've got 2 additional perks to go, and I can't remember exactly what level in Illusion we need to be in order to get Quiet Casting, but if you're not familiar, Quiet Casting is going to allow us to cast all of our spells silently, which is going to be a huge advantage for us since every time we use our bound bow spell, we're making some noise. So that's going to be a necessity for us. Interesting point about that as well is it's also effective with shouts. So essentially you can use all your shout powers without making any noise, which is kind of interesting. There's a lot you can do with that when you really think about it. So that has to be a huge priority for us. Now, one thing that we have at our disadvantage right now is that because of the path that Fleet is choosing, we're not getting a ton of exposure yet to individuals who can train us in Conjuration or Illusion. There was a gentleman I believe, in Falkreath, who could have trained us in that area, but I never really crossed paths with him. So what that's going to force us to do is really acquire some of these the hard way. We're really moving toward the Dark Brotherhood quest line and probably the Thieves Guild quest line. So I may do a little research to find out who the trainers are that we might run into. But in the meantime, we have to keep leveling in these. So really, to do that, we're going to kind of plod forward. We're going to be using a lot of muffle, which is always to our advantage. And we're going to be using a lot of our bound bow, which will help us, you know, at least slowly and methodically level both of those. And then, you know, if along the way we find someone who can give us some training to kind of accelerate that, then that's great. So far, I've actually been surprisingly disciplined in the way that I've been spending my perk points. A lot of times I'm just kind of willy-nilly, but with this particular character, I had a very clear plan about what I wanted to do from the start, and I have not invested any perks in any areas that I hadn't planned to from the start. So typically what I've been doing here is every time I go up a level, if I've got a perk to spend, I basically look down all those core skill areas. If I do not have one that's open, or I don't have an available spending opportunity in one of those core areas, I don't spend it. I keep the perk in reserve until I acquire a level in something. So usually I'll go up and kind of breeze through my levels and see what I'm close on, and then if I focus a little bit, sometimes I can get a couple extra levels and bump something up. But I have not invested any perks in things I hadn't planned to, so that's unusual for me. Usually I get a perk or two to spend, and I'm like a kid in a candy store, and I see all kinds of things that look interesting. One thing I haven't done yet that we're going to need to start doing soon is investing in crafting. I've got this target in mind that once I reach level 20, I'll feel relatively safe in starting to invest in crafting. And by crafting, for this character, as we've mentioned before, is primarily alchemy perks and enchanting perks. But for now, up to level 20, I'm going to be investing my perks in those core assassin skills and the illusion and conjuration. Remember, we are an arcane archer. So those things are important, and we're sacrificing some stealth perks and some smithing perks to get there. Man, that sounds threatening, doesn't it? Sounds awful close. We're just going to ease our way out of there. So we are in travel mode again. Being very careful, methodical, making sure to watch our flanks. Whenever possible, staying off the main trail. Using the terrain to our advantage to get an occasional overlook before we go into an area. And also doing things like putting rock faces and objects to either our left and right, so that we've only got one area to watch. So we're on the road right now, but very soon the road is going to continue up the mountain, kind of heading south. Where we really want to go is east. The trail is going to be a more direct route east, so we're going to take the trail. Once we get to that point, we're going to have to be even more careful because the terrain around the trail narrows significantly, and it's filled with lots of twists and turns and switchbacks, which means our field of a view, or our view to the horizon is severely limited, which becomes dangerous. So we will deal with that. Looks like we got some hunters here. Don't need any more snout. There's no reason we can't steal from these guys, though. They seem to be preoccupied at the moment, so mammoth tusks are worth a little bit. We have the carrying capacity. We certainly aren't made of money at this point, so always looking for opportunities to make a little extra money. There we go, level 16. The leveling is actually still coming pretty rapidly, and in case you've forgotten, right now we are still using the Guardian Stone for Warrior. As soon as I advance to the point where I'm down near Markarth, I'll probably switch to the Lover Stone, but we have not had any reason to go that far west yet. So for now, I'm just content to go where the story leads me, and right now the story leads me to Riften, so this poor sap probably got crushed by the giants. I'm assuming that if you're watching this, it's because A, you're just either interested in Let's Plays in general, or you're interested specifically in sort of assassin or archer focused Let's Plays. I would be interested to hear how you like to play an archer or an assassin. Let me know down in the comments. We've been having some good discussion lately in the comments about a number of different things. Gear, techniques and spells, stuff like that. So feel free to chime in. I'm always interested in hearing what other people are doing. There's also been some discussion about what it would take to get me to start doing Let's Plays on a PC. So, you know, I'm considering that. There are a number of different things that I could invest in, and I think that being able to convert my Let's Plays to PC and use mods would really do a lot to enrich what I'm doing here. I feel like the content is pretty good, the quality's pretty good so far, but I love the idea of, you know, some of the cool mods being put in play for my Let's Plays. So just for the record, I am seriously considering going the PC route. I've also done some investigation on what it would take to convert my saved game for Fleet to PC, and it sounds like it can be done without too much hassle. So, just for the record, I am considering it. I did recently also invest in some upgraded hardware for doing my production work, so I think we'll start to see some of the benefits of that in the not too distant future. What's going on over there? I still can't get over how strange it is to not see dragons in Skyrim. So there's a guy over here. I'm going to see if I can draw him over here. I think, if I remember correctly, he's an orc who's looking for challengers. He's essentially preparing himself to die. I'm not interested in fighting him, but I am interested in these saber cats. So We appear to be sneaky enough to get right up behind them, so I'm going to go ahead and raid these things, looking for teeth and hides. What do you got? Nothing worth taking. You didn't even know we were here. Love stealth. Generally, I am a stealth player through and through. Why that is? That style of play just, I guess, fits my sensibilities. So in just about every game I've played, I've always gone the stealth character route. Doing it here, obviously, pretty consistently, but I've done it also in many, many other games. Fallout comes to mind, for example. Always going the stealth route there. Alright, we're still pretty close to the road. I'm feeling like I'm down too low, so this trail is sort of the path of least resistance to get up on top of these rocks. We're gonna go up a little higher, get a bird's eye view of what's coming up. The objective here, obviously, is to always keep our advantage, and the second we're spotted, we lose our advantage. So, it takes a little extra work and some thought. You gotta carefully pick your paths from one place to another, but if you do that, there's no reason why you can't get the jump on just about anybody. Let's check in here since we're cruising by, see if there's any loot. If I remember correctly, you have an option here to get to the main chamber. This is just a really small area, but to get to the main chamber that is to our left, you can go straight through the gate, but you're contending with a master lock, or you can go this route through this door and another interior door and contend with two adept level locks. So I'm going to go the adept route. I guess I could pick the master for fun too and just get levels, but I don't feel like I have a big enough reserve of lockpicks yet that I want to do that. I'm not really going to take any of this dwarven metal. It's all just too heavy, too bulky. We'll look in the chest, though. At least sell. All right, let's try this one. Well, we found the soft spot anyway. I am not going to take that shard. And I wouldn't advise taking that shard if I were you. I would take it if you'd already started the quest line for it. But I've had an experience where I took that shard in advance of starting the quest line, and then it actually broke my quest and I wasn't able to finish it. So just a little word of advice there. If you haven't done the Ethereum Wars quest line, keep that in mind. Well, dear viewers, we've reached the end of this episode. I thank you for taking the journey with me. And until next time, may all that you do be swift, quiet, and deadly. And to all Skyrim assassins, I salute you. Silence is our battle cry. You've been watching Aranis Arcana, a Skyrim Let's Play. If you liked this video, please rate, like, and subscribe. For more information on this and other Couch Warrior broadcasts, visit me on the web at www.couchwarrior.tv.